Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
In this video, I will analyze Stref Foundation in Safe version 12. Dead load and live load on concentric foundation column is 150 kip and 200 kip respectively. Dead load and live load on eccentric foundation column is 200 kip and 300 kip respectively. Each column size of 24 inch by 24 inch. Soil bearing capacity is 2 TSF. Center to center distance between column is 24 feet. Strap beam connecting both foundation initially taken as 24 inch by 36 inch. Use FC prime equals to 4 KSI and FY equals to 60 KSI. In Safe software, go to File, click on New Model. Design code, I am selecting ACI 31808. Check units consistency, set to be kip and fit. For design parameter, click on Modify Show. According to ACI 31808, phi tension controlled is 0.9, phi compression controlled is 0.65 and phi shear is 0.75. Go to Minimum Cover Slab tab. Clear cover bottom and top will be 3 inch for foundation according to ACI code. Go to Minimum Cover Beam tab. Clear cover beam and top will be 1.5 inch for beam according to ACI code. Click on Grid Only. X direction grid spacing is 24 feet as we have 24 feet center to center distance between columns. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Materials. 4000 PSI concrete already defined. Go to Define. Click on Slab Properties. Click on Add New Property. Uncheck Thick Plate option. Defining 30 inch thick foundation. Slab material is 4000 PSI. Select Type to Footing. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Beam Properties. Click on Add New Property. Defining 24 inch by 36 inch beam. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Soil Subgrade Properties. Click on Modify Show Property. Defining 2 TSF soil having subgrade modulus equals to 12 into safety factor into bearing capacity. We have safety factor equals to 3, so it is 2 multiplied 2.2046 multiplied 1000 multiplied 36, which is equals to 158731.2 pound per foot cube. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Column Properties. Click on Add New Property. Defining column of 24 inch by 24 inch having FC prime equals to 4 KSI. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Load Patterns. Change dead load self multiplier to 0, so Safe will not take foundation self weight during analyzing. Should not be done for real projects. I did only for learning purpose. Click on OK. Go to Define. Click on Load Combinations. Click on Add Default Design Combos. Check Strength Ultimate and Service Initial. UDCON U1 is 1.4 dead load. UDCON U2 is 1.2 dead load and 1.6 live load. Click on OK. Go to Draw. Click on Quick Draw Areas Around Points. Let's first find out initial area of foundation using service load. We have service load of 350 kip on eccentrically foundation column, so area required is 350 divided by 4.4 equals to 79.5 feet square. I am providing 6 feet by 15 feet foundation size. For concentric foundation column, we have service load of 500 kip, so area required is 500 divided by 4.5 equals to 113.6 feet square. For concentric foundation, length width of foundation equals to square root of 113.6 feet square equals to 10.66 feet square. So I am providing 10.75 feet by 10.75 feet foundation size. Select eccentric foundation, which is at this time concentric foundation. Go to Edit, click on Move Points, Loads, Areas. Distance from edge of footing to center is 3 feet, subtract with column half dimension, that is 1 feet. So delta x input is 2 feet. Go to draw, click on draw columns. Column height below is 0 feet with none property. Column height above is 10 feet with property above of column 24 inch by 24 inch. Go to draw, click on beams lines. Draw beam from column center to center. Select both foundations. Go to assign, support data, and click on soil properties. Select true TSF and click OK to assign true TSF soil. Select column start points. Go to assign, support data, and click on point restraints. Click on none joint and click on OK. Select column start point of eccentric foundation. Go to assign, load data, and click on point load. Input gravity Z dead load to 150 kip. Click on OK. Similarly, select column start point of concentric foundation. Go to assign, load data, and click on point load. Input gravity Z load to 200 kip. Click on OK. Similarly, applying live load on both column points. Go to define load combinations. Defining service load combination of 1.0 dead load plus 1.0 live load. Go to run, click on run analysis and design. Go to display, click on deform shape. Select load combination to service and click on apply. Check maximum and minimum deflection values are minus 0.24 inch and minus 0.39 inch at bottom left screen of software. Deflection should be less than as mentioned in soil report to avoid excessive settlement. Go to display, click on reaction forces. Select load combination to service. Choose soil pressure from option type of reactions. Click on apply. Allowable soil pressure is 2 TSF multiplied 2.2046 multiplied 1000 equals to 4409.2 pound per feet square. Soil pressure should be less than this value. Minimum soil pressure value is 5138 pound per feet square, which is more than allowable. Need to increase footing dimension. Eccentric foundation is not safe in soil pressure limit, so let's increase its size in Y direction. I am also increasing beam depth to 42 inches. Select footing edges. Go to edit, edit area, and click on expand shrink areas. Input offset value to 18 inch. Go to run and click on run analysis and design. Soil pressure reduces to 4381 pound per feet square, which is less than allowable value of 4409.2 pound per feet square. So now foundation is safe in deflection as well as in soil pressure. I will design this foundation using FEM or finite element method and strip method. Also design strip beam in next video. Also I will show you detailing of strip beam in safe version 12. Subscribe to my channel and press bell icon so you will never miss any new video. Like, share and comment below in comment section. If you need any assistance related to structural design, you can contact me through email address. Also, you can send me suggestion of videos to be made.